Representing the boxers, and in the red corner, representing the People's Republic of China, the 2008 world champion, Jinzi. And in the blue corner, representing the Russian Federation, the world number one, Nadezda, Torlopova. Seconds out, round one.
So the opening bell sound in this women's 75 kilogram middleweight semi-final between the boxer wearing red, representing China, Li Jinzi, and her opponent wearing blue, representing Russia, and the 2C in the tournament, Nadezda Torlopova. Both of these boxers hugely experienced. 22 years old is Li, but already competed in four world championships. Gold medalist in 2008. She beat Sweden's Anna Laurel in the final. There's Nadezda. Torlopova, 33 years of age. She's competed two world championships and took the gold medal at 81 kilograms plus in 2010.
Torlopova just telegraphing her punches there a little bit. She lifts the elbow before she throws both the jab and the backhand. Perhaps that's just a bit of nerves going into this round. But bundles Li over to the floor. More of a push than a punch. The gloves down and they carry on.
Torlopova, the number 2 seed, with a bronze medal from the recent World Championships in China, losing to the woman who went on to become the world champion, Savannah Marshall. She was the number 1 seed in this tournament, as she was eliminated at the quarterfinal stage. Had a bye in the opening round by virtue of that number 1 seed. Huge upset. The number 1 seed was ousted early, which really blew this tournament wide open. Third, with proficient boxers at the 12 who lined up at the start of the tournament. At the final 4 stage, and this is the semi-final between Li, representing China, and the opponent from Russia, Torlopova.
I think at this stage, Torlopova has probably landed the more, the cleaner shots, beg your pardon. She's stalking Li. He's catching her on the counter.
There's a bell sound to bring back and into the first round. What is going to stop those counters? And just enough to give Li a 1-point advantage by a score of 4-3.
Just telegraph your punches. You can see this. Counters and moves off.
So into the second round we go. It is scheduled for 4 team rounds in this winning 75 kilogram middleweight semi-final between the boxer Wall and Red. Enjoying deft footwork at the moment, that is Blue Jinzi, who scores with a long, strong right cross. And the number 2 seed, Rowing Blue, representing Russia. And there's the Torlopova, the bronze medalist from the most recent World Championships in China, just a few months ago.
Good start by Lee here, asserting her authority first, being first to the punch. It's good to see that she can throw the shot, the single shots, move off, come back with their second phase.
Yeah, 22 years ago, the first real experience in the international scene, started boxing as a 14-year-old before making an international debut the 2006 World Championships for China. Torlopova, conversely, 33 years of age. She didn't start boxing until 2005 when she took her 6-year-old son to the gym, her then 6-year-old son to the gym while she was doing her own exercise program, doing it to get in shape, stay in shape, because she lands a forceful right hand. But then her coach told her husband, as Lee replies with a good left hook, coach said to her husband, and Torlopova, of course, that he thinks she's got good potential in boxing. They had a family discussion. Julie took up the sport, increased her commitment to training, was crowned world champion in 2010, and here she is, competing on the Olympic stage as the reigning world championship bronze medalist as well.
Torlopova just looking a little bit more pedestrian out of the two. Slower punches, most definitely. And the more static footwork. Little punch after the stop there.
To watch that in front of the boxing referee will only say stop, box and break. And the boxers to heed the instructions and then look out for the stipulations at the hands of the referee. Good right hand just on the belt from Torlopova. And rock the head back, and that's adjusted the headgear in the
scored more counter punches, but Torlopova definitely the stronger boxer here, which is landing caught. Lee there with a right uppercut as she bobs down, and a short chopping left hand there on the clinch twice, in fact, and finishes it off with a right bowler punch. Getting countered herself by Lee with a left jab. Looping right hand there by Torlopova. Left hand, right hand, snapping the head back of Lee. I suspect that was the last punch of the bout, last punch of the round. Bring it to score.
Three.
We move into the second half of this winning 75 kilogram middleweight semi-final. From the boxer wearing red, representing China, Lee Jinzi. Representing Russia at the tournament number 2 seed and reigning world championship Nadezda, two-time European champion, is Torlopova, the reigning champ from last year, took the title in 2009, plus 81 kilograms, her current title is in the 75 kilogram middleweight division, to come down to his heaviest weight class here at the Olympic Games.
Lee needs to lead off here. She knows she's quicker than Torlopova. She needs to lead off, force Torlopova to counter, and then counter with her own strong shots and move off. She's waiting for Torlopova, and actually Torlopova's landing those first shots. There we go with a beautiful right hand there by Torlopova.
Out of harm's way.
Lee is losing a little bit of her form here, falling in with the shots, getting a little bit desperate. She needs to hold her concentration, hold her boxing technique.
Good right hand from Torlopova. Beginning to take an effect on me because her work just a little more ragged than we've seen it in her preceding contest. Again, she's being picked off by that left jab, but the boxer's wrestling on the inside of the clinch. And again, we suspect that favours Torlopova after we do the boxer.
Absolutely, yeah, they must be taking their toll. We can see Lee's form dropping, losing her concentration towards the end of that round there. And Torlopova making the most of that advantage.
Contest that was tied at 6 points apiece has now swung to give Torlopova a 2-point lead, 10 points to 8 in the scoreline, with one round of boxing to go.
Great right hand, left hand there by Torlopova, right on the button. And again, 1-2, finishing off with a long jab, knocking Lee's head back like a rag doll. Right hook there to finish, throwing Lee off balance. Urgency in the blue corner there for the Russian boxer.
This 75 kilogram weight class, the naturally bigger of the two athletes, and I suspect that that extra size and natural strength is beginning to take its toll in exchanges like this. The clinches, the grappling, the mauling on the inside is just wearing out Lee, who demonstrated superb footwork and movement in her preceding Olympic bouts.
Yes, one of the only ways to negate speed and this sheer physicality that Torlopova is demonstrating here is really taking it out of Lee. She's losing her form, she's losing her speed and her technique, and actually the confidence to actually throw. Wrestling here, both of the boxers, and Lee running out of ideas.
Introduced a brilliant display in her quarter-final victory over Canada's Mary Spencer, the legendary figure of Mary Spencer, to win by a score of 17 points to 14. Looked really good during that quarter-final bout. An immovable object here. Torlopova content to lean on at close quarters, is really taking it out of Lee. His desperate work hasn't been in evidence in this Olympic semi-final. Single shot again from Torlopova. As we approach the closing bell, I suspect that the number two seed will have done enough to progress through to the gold medal game. Five with her coaches in the blue corner. It's rather more resigned expression, perhaps one of defeat in the face of Lee. What a tour de force performance that was from the number two seed. Immensely physical, as the contest progressed.
We are the battle of two world champions here. But Torlopova reigns supreme, I believe, with her strength, her physicality, and just purely wore Lee down towards the end of that bout. Lee lost her speed and her technique. Torlopova was quite happy to take that advantage. Finished the bout incredibly strongly.
The reason for the delay in announcing the score, lots of conferring and consultation going on.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner by score of 12 points to 10 in the blue corner, representing the Russian Federation, Nadezda Torlopova.
See the number 2 seed, Nadezda Torlopova of Russia, books her place in the gold medal bag.
And your research also, please, for Jinzi.
And look at that, the celebrations in that blue corner. Absolutely delighted, and well she should be.